Hello, welcome to this month's video vlog. This month's topic will be on our retro line system, but more specifically, an application in which this product can be utilized as what we refer to as an outdoor intersection. In many cases, there could be a situation in which a full-length retro line system may not be required. This might be because you have a pipe buried deep enough below the frost line between the building and the lake, and you may only want a short length of heating cable system, say from the lake going into the water. This would be used to reduce the upfront capital cost, but more specifically, to not necessarily run energy if it is not required. The retro line system can be outfitted with a coupling arrangement. The coupling arrangement is what's going to allow us to be able to interface this product down by the shoreline as an example. On our website, on the RetroLine product page, you will find a document that will be specific to the RetroLine outdoor intersection application. This document will illustrate and show specifically what is required to be able to set the system up in this manner. What I have here is a short demonstration of componentry that's necessary to be able to introduce the RetroLine system in an outdoor intersection application. I have a T-fitting and I have a short length of poly pipe with a sweeping 90 degree bend that would be transferring up to the surface. The T-fitting is buried below the surface, ideally below the frost line. This portion coming to the surface, this portion of the T will be running towards the lake, and off of the branch there would be a sweep bend created that would be heading back towards the home. The stub portion is actually what's going to allow us to introduce the retro line from the surface. It'll feed through the sweep, straight through the T, running out down towards the lake. The reason we have configured this arrangement as an outdoor intersection is many people will want to bury the retro line connections in the ground, which is really not what you want to do, because by doing so, you will lose serviceability of the system. By creating this sweeping 90 degree bend and using the stub pipe to come up to the surface, this will allow us to actually interface the retro line above ground, energize the system, but yet maintain constant serviceability of the product through its years of service. So with the retro line system now installed inside the pipe, we have the coupling, the electrical connection, which is above ground. The system would then be powered via a 4x4 or a 6x6 post that would be at the surface, with power being brought down to that location. I hope you found this video vlog helpful. We will continue to release a video vlog every month. Please make sure to sign up to our email newsletter, Facebook, or any of our other social media pages. Thank you for watching.